The courtyard and gardens surrounding the manor were once a point of pride for the diligent custodians I employed. Great banquets and lavish social affairs were hosted here under the stars. Despite the expectation of propriety normally ascribed to those in our position, we mocked the stoic melancholy of the moss-covered fountains and cherubic statues, our salacious trysts half hidden in the hedgerows, our morality slipping ever deeper into the mud. Soaked and sinking, these stone terraces and sprawling gardens were the site of long-forgotten revelry and well-remembered regret. A handsome reward for a task well performed. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Press this advantage. Give them no quarter. Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. Formation is broken. Maintain the offensive. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms. These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten. Thank you.
is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Precision and power. This momentum. Push on to the task's end. Another abomination cleansed from our lands. A trifling victory. But a victory nonetheless.
mutation. Unnatural and abhorrent. This expedition, at least, promises success.
Slowly. Gently. This is how a life is taken.
The maddening whine of multitudinous wings abates. Let us hope that is the end of things. In those younger years, my home was a hive of unbridled hedonism. A roiling apiary where instinct and impulse were indulged with wild abandon. A bewitching predator slipped in amidst the swarm of tittering sycophants. Though outwardly urbane, I could sense in her a mocking thirst. Driven half-mad by cloying vulgarity, I plotted to rid myself of this lurking threat in a grand display of sadistic sport. But as the moment of murder drew nigh, the gibbous moon revealed her inhuman desires in all their stultifying hideousness. These swarming fiends carry a pernicious plague. A sickness so virulent, so insidious. It is more a curse than a mere disease.